What is happening, guys? Mike here. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're taking a look at two of the more recently requested reviews. Not just one, but two reviews that you guys have been asking for a lot from the infamous Shear Revival. We got the all-new Amity Texture Spray and the newly reformulated American Gardens in this all-new product review. All right, once again, welcome back to the channel. Welcome to all you awesome subscribers here. If you're new and not yet a subscriber, I would like to welcome you here as well. This is Modern Man TV, and here you're going to find some of the most in-depth reviews on grooming products and various things here on YouTube. And I would love for you to join us here on the channel. So if you haven't yet already, hit that subscribe button. That's a big deal. I really appreciate that. But today we are talking about a couple of new products from Shear Revival. This is one of those classic brands that I've reviewed a bunch of times in the past, and I've looked at a lot of their stuff in depth. And really, I think they're one of those brands that when they release something new, you pay attention to it, and you at least give it a second look. We will be looking again at both the Amity and American Gardens here in this video. And Amity is a brand new product, actually. We haven't yet seen this one. It's a texture spray, which is awesome. But American Gardens, I think, is especially cool because it's a reformulation. Enough chit chat though, I know you guys just want to jump into these and see what they're all about. So let's start as usual with some specs on each one of these, starting first with the Amity Texture Spray. According to the brand, the new Amity Texture Spray is a new take on the everyday sea salt spray. Using a combination of sea salt from the Atlantic Ocean and Australian kale and clay, it adds tons of texture, volume, and structure to your look. They also go on to say that using aloe leaf juice and witch hazel as the base carrier not only makes your hair and scalp stay hydrated, but witch hazel specifically aids in promoting healthy hair growth and slowing down hair loss. They also say that they achieve the other results using key ingredients including aloe again, marula oil, carnauba wax, and bamboo extract. For scent here, we got sage and bergamot, and it comes in an 8-ounce bottle for $18 US. Moving right over to the American Gardens. Now this one, once again, is a brand new formulation of the classic oil-based clay offered by this brand. The new version features an aloe-based formula, and again, according to them, this was made using a combination of their past formulas of limited edition products. They also claim this to be 100% washable and a vegan formula with 99% plant-derived ingredients, producing a strong hold with a dry, matte finish. To top it off, it features a wild orange and oak moss fragrance created with therapeutic-grade essential oils, and they also call this their strongest and driest product to date. As usual, this one comes in their standard 4-ounce jar and sells for $18 US. Now with the Amity, there's really not much to show you on that as far as like looking inside the bottle here. I mean, it's a liquid inside of a sprayer, but I can tell you that the sprayer actually does work very well. There's no jetting or anything like that. It comes out in a nice mist, so it's very functional and that everything's good there. Moving over to the American Gardens though, we can look inside the jar on this one, and when we do, we see a very different looking clay compared to what the original one was. When digging into it, here you get kind of a picture of what it is, what this new one is, and it's quite thick. I mean, it's almost a back of the nail scooper for sure, but once it's in the hand, it does break down fairly easily. You still do need some pressure for sure. You know, you have to really apply some pressure to it, but it's not a huge deal because it does have somewhat of a smooth feel to it as well, which does help in the breakdown. Once you do break it down, you do get a big dose of that dryness. You can really tell this is a dry clay, and that just appears right away, and it really gives you a kind of warning shot about how the styling is gonna go. Personally, I do think that the dryness, this is a really good feature because it can kind of give you a heads up if you're about to use too much. You can really tell how it feels in your hand, you know, so you can not overly do it when you throw it in your hair. But speaking of using it and all that stuff, let's just jump straight into the demos here. We're gonna start actually with the American Gardens. And I'm starting with this one here because I think this one has a little bit more explanation explanation to it. And after using it in both dry and damp hair, of course, this is how I do every one of my reviews. I test it in multiple methods, things like that. For me, dry hair produced better results as usual. I did try it in damp hair. I just felt like dry hair produced a little bit better results. I am starting here with freshly washed and dried hair. This does not, though, have the Amity spray included. That will be a separate demo. So no pre-stylers or tonic included here on this one. And I'm using a total of 2 scoops on dry hair. And again, when using it, that dryness does put itself front and center in the scoop and in the hand, and that does transfer right away into your hair. But surprisingly, once you start actually using it, it's not as dry as I was expecting. It for sure feels drier in the hand, I think, than in the hair, especially that first scoop. The first scoop is actually quite lightweight, so it's not taking over as much. And this is the reason why I use the second scoop, so that I could get it all through my hair and get that full clay effect. Once the second scoop is applied, I think it's got a dry, sticky, tacky presence that feels like it's really putting in some good work in the hold department. It just feels like a typical clay. It feels a lot like what a clay should be. I'm not quite sure that strong is the appropriate term for the hold strength, but I do think the hold really makes itself known, and that's a great situation to be in because that's typically what you want to see with something like this. The next thing, of course, that we have to look at, though, is endurance. And because we are looking at a second product here, I'm just going to skip to the end of day results. What I think we have here overall hold wise is actually something quite good for being 8 hours in. I mean, really, hold wise, we're in great shape for being 8 hours in. I do think it's fair to say some volume has dropped a tiny bit. I think that's kind of what I'm seeing here. But again, this is 8 hours in. I think it looks pretty freaking good. Now, though, we're going to switch on over to the Amity Texture Spray so I can show you guys what this is all about here. For this demo, I'm using it the usual way for texture sprays, which is on damp hair and then blow drying, so a pretty generic pre-styling scenario. And for the demo here, I did reset my hair. I washed it out completely. You know, I took everything out so that I could start fresh with this. And I got to tell you, when I first went in with the spray here, I kind of got Spider-Man'd by the bottle. It totally threw me off guard there. I for sure wasn't expecting to look like Ben Stiller in There's Something About Mary. Moving past this, though, I am going to spray this all around here. Nothing really special to see. I'm just, you know, spraying it around my head a couple times. And then I'm just working it in with my fingers, making sure it gets, you know, totally into the hair everywhere I want it to go. And then I hit it with the heat. That's pretty much it. This is what I got. And really what I think we got here is something that's pretty polished, which is nice. Really, you can tell that it's actually putting in some work, which for some sea salt sprays is a big issue. Here, though, you can see it does have an actual effect, and that effect is really not bad. I do think we have a little bit of hold there, a little volume, a little texture. You know, for me, it's just, you know, things in little bits, which is typical because I do have thick hair. I do also think, though, everything is in place for the most part. Overall, based on first appearances, I am seeing everything that they claim that this has, which is good. Of course, how much of this that I'm seeing, like how much of the results that I'm seeing, is a different story, but I am going to save that for the final thoughts. Because one thing that I figured was that you guys would want to see how these work together, how the spray and the clay work together. So what I did real quick was that style that you just saw here with the spray, I took that and I ran some American Gardens through it to test out what the results were. And really, I gotta say, I think this looks really good. I mean, everything that we saw in the first demo is there, plus everything that we saw in the second demo is there. It's combined, obviously, being it's two different products, but the main thing that I really liked about it was the fact that I didn't need 2 scoops of the American Gardens after using the spray. I was able to achieve this look with using just 1 scoop, so I think that's a pretty cool effect. When that happens, you're able to pre-style with something, you end up having to use less product. That's always a plus for me. For time's sake, though, let's move on here. Let's get into the little details, and I'll do one after another to save time on that. Starting first with the scent, and I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time on this because they are both awesome scents. And I think that this is an area actually that Shear Revival has never really had issues in. And you know, their scents are not super complex, but they're really nice. They're refreshing. And as somebody with a fragrance allergy, they don't tend to bother me at all. It's just, you know, it's really super easy to explain. They're very fresh. I think it's very typical of their line, and I have no complaints there at all. I almost knocked this over. For the washout, I also think that's also super easy. I felt each one needed shampoo. I do think that in regards to both of them, you can get almost all of it out with water. There's just a little bit that I felt left with each one, that I felt there's some stuff left behind that the shampoo needed to come in and pull all the way out. So that, I mean, that like in the case of the American Gardens, there's just a little bit of dryness left over from the clay. And so shampoo pulled that out. But again, as I always say, one shampoo for me still qualifies as an easy washout, because I wash my hair every day, and I don't think it's a big deal to have to use shampoo to get something out of your hair. It's really not that big a deal. Now though, let's talk about the performance that we saw with each one of these, getting into my final thoughts here. Let's start first with Amity. This here is a spray that I'm personally a fan of. I do like it a lot. I think it's worlds ahead of some others that I've seen on the market, because for me, this one actually has a really good effect. Because for me, not only does it have an effect, it actually does something, but it actually does it pretty well. And again, in this community, we have a lot of different sprays out there. You know, sea salt spray specifically, they claim to offer, you know, an effect, and then they don't have anything. You know, you have a ton of sprays out there like that. So when it's really refreshing to me as a reviewer to see a spray that claims to have these things and then comes through and actually provides it. Now, I did mention, you know, the level, like how much of that am I actually seeing? So I think everything's light, and that's exactly what they said it has, you know, light hold, this and that. I do think the texture is a little bit low. That's going to be my criticism for it. The texture is a little bit low. I think that I would have liked to see a little bit more hold out of it. For somebody with my hair type, you know, a thicker hair type, I would have really loved to have seen a little bit more hold, maybe a little bit more volume. I wasn't too critical over that. There is some hold there, and as you saw in a pre-styling scenario, it worked really well, you know, because the post-styler came in to bridge the gap, and I was actually able to use less post-styler. That was great. I also think in regards to hair types with the Amity, that you guys with fine straight hair, you guys are going to love this, because that light hold, what was, you know, a little bit lighter for me, is going to translate into a heavier hold for you. So I think your guys are going to love this spray. It's going to really result in a lot more actual identifiable results for you guys. And then you guys with thick hair, I'd wager that you're going to experience right around the same for me, which is still good. I'm not trying to make it sound good, but I always like to provide some pieces of feedback, some pieces of criticism, and that would be it for me in regards to the spray. Moving over to American Gardens, though, I do have to say I really like this formula better than the original. It's not greasy. It's completely different, and I did like the original, but I do really like where they went with this new formula, too. I think it's a really great update, and I actually would have to agree also that it's probably the driest product that I've seen come from Shear Revival. I think comparatively though, it does somewhat compare to quite a few clays that I've seen in the past. I don't want to go out on the limb and say that this formula is revolutionary or something completely separate. I feel like that, you know, in the consistency, the performance, things like that, it is somewhat typical to a lot of clays that we've seen, and that list is just, it's just so long. It would take me all day to list them all, and I'm not trying to, you know, say anything bad, but, you know, it would just take all day to go down and compare and contrast all of them. So let me just describe in detail again what we have real quick, and you can take that and then compare it to whatever clay you're looking at. It's thick in the scoop, it's smooth in the breakdown. When applying to the hair, it's both dry and sticky, and as you add more of it, obviously it becomes more dry and more sticky, but it also becomes really nice and smooth, so it is nicely balanced. I don't think it's quite on the dryness. I don't think it's quite on the level of, say, like the O'Dowd's matte paste. That's a pretty dry one. I don't think it's quite up there because that smoothness balances out, but it does have a slight tug to it. I think it's got a little bit of tug in there, which I actually happen to prefer, by the way. I think the tug is perfect for me because it gives me that really nice hold strength to go along with the tug, but, you know, that's to each his own on that one. But it's an important detail to note, though, that it does have some tug, because I know some of you guys look for that. I also, again, really liked how they counteracted the dryness and that little bit of tug with a super smooth presentation. I think that was just an essential and a brilliant move on their part to formulate it that way, to counteract. In regards to the hold, though, I actually found it to be more than adequate. I'd call it firm for sure. That's just my opinion. And one thing I liked about it was the fact that it had presentable hold, but the clays actually provided a little bit of hold as well. And so that really helped in that all-day endurance. For hair types, types, I have to go with pretty much the same as Amity. I do think all hair types are going to find some use in this. If you want to try it out, I think no matter what hair type you got, you're going to be able to use this depending on how you use it. I think with thin or fine haired people, some of you are going to appreciate the tug, some of you are not. If you use it in small amounts and smooth your hair out, you can eliminate that tug, or you know, at least reduce it. But I really think that if some of you get past the little bit of tug, you will, and you have thin or fine hair, you're going to really love the texture, the volume, the hold. I mean, this one could be a great product for you. For you guys with thick hair, same thing. You know, I used 2 scoops and had 8 hours endurance. I mean, it's absolutely there. All of the attributes are absolutely there for you guys with thick hair as well. And so I do really think this was a well-made clay. And speaking of that word clay, we're going into my criticism here on this one. I don't see this as a clay pomade. I absolutely get why they kept the name. It's iconic. People already know it. I probably would have done the same thing in their position, honestly. But just so everyone knows, I don't feel like this is a clay pomade. It's not a clay pomade as we know it today. This has more in relation to a styling clay, in my opinion, because of how it performs, how it just goes into that hair with that dry, high volume texture. There's really no shine at all. So I just felt like that. The next thing though is the scoop. It is a bit thick, and when you're trying to scoop it out, it actually, for me, it started to spin in the jar because it was so thick. It was just, you know, while it's spinning, I'm trying to get a scoop, so it made it a little bit hard to scoop out. But other than that, well done, Shear Revival. Other than that, you know, Zach over at Shear Revival, you did a great job on this one. I really appreciate you guys sending it out for me to review. That is pretty much it on this one, though. I think, again, they did a great job. I really loved the updates and the new products. I think Shear Revival is still going strong, and that's awesome. I'm really happy for all of them over there. Of course, if you would like to check these out, I will have links in the description there. I highly recommend you check out this brand. I've been a big fan of them for a long time. If you have any questions or something I forgot to touch on, throw it in the comment section. I'll do my best to help some of you guys out there. If you could do your part while you're there, like this video, drop me a comment, you know, subscribe if you haven't already. Once again, that's a big deal to the channel. If you hit that subscribe button, turn on those notifications. If you haven't already, I got some awesome content coming out, including some reviews, hair care, skin care. I have actually probably 5 behind the brews that I'm working on right now too. So I got a lot of awesome content for you. So hit that subscribe button. Turn on the bell icon. I really appreciate that. That's pretty much it for today, though. Take it easy. I'll see you next time.